I'm a scat man. I'm a scat man. I'm a scat man. I'm a scat man. I'm a scat man.
Top of the morning, McLean. I'm Arman.
And I'm Rebecca.
Hey, Rebecca, can you believe there's only 2 weeks of school left?
No, it's crazy. It seems like it was just yesterday that it was the first day of school.
You know what I've missed the most?
What?
Hearing Ben Shue do the Pledge of Allegiance. Let's hear it one last time.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all, if you so choose. For today's mountful moment of silence, please be right on the how this first week of spring has been
different
than expected. Thank you, and have a great day, Highlights of the Nation!
Thanks, Ben. Now to McLean News. McLean seniors picked up their diplomas and caps and gowns this weekend, and teachers showed up to cheer them on as they drove by. Check out McLean's Twitter and Instagram to see pictures of the seniors.
Seniors voted on their Teachers of the Year, and the winners are Miss Billingsley and Mr. Brockety. Mr. Craner is this year's recipient from the Norma DeCorda Award. Congratulations to them and to all the great teachers who have supported the seniors for the past 4 years.
I don't know about you, but I could really use some fresh new shoes. Let's see what Daniel recommends.
Hi, McLean. This is Daniel, and today for sneaker review, we shall be reviewing the Yeezy 350 Yeshua colorway. So, right off the bat, these are a great looking sneaker, you know, designed by Kanye West, retailing for $220. The resale is in between $300 to like $330 for a DS pair. These were a limited release sneaker that only was available in America and China, so that's why they're a little more expensive. As you can see, they look amazing, like really nice looking sneaker. It has a gum bottom, a sort of like a translucent glassy area, and just like a sort of a static upper. So that is for my review, and see you next week.
Thanks, Daniel. Attention all freshmen and sophomores. You will now be able to pick up your gym uniforms that are in your lockers. Complete the Google form that was provided by your gym teacher to make sure that you can pick up your uniforms. Now to Kate with weather.
Hey McLean, it's Kate with your weather. Today in McLean, you should expect mostly sunny skies with a high of 75 and a low of 54. There should be no rain today. Now for your 3-day weather forecast. On Tuesday, temperatures will rise a bit with a high of 78 and a low of 67. It'll be pretty cloudy in the morning, but the sky should clear up a bit in the afternoon, leaving partly cloudy skies. Wednesday will continue the cloud trend with partly cloudy skies. There's a chance of a thunderstorm as well. Temperatures will be even hotter with a high of 94 and a low of 71. And finally, on Thursday, temperatures will cool down a bit with a high of 87 and a low of 67, but the weather will be the opposite with likely thunderstorms all day. Today or tomorrow will be the nicest days of the week, so I suggest spending some time outside now before you see showers later in the week. That's all for your weather, now back to your anchors.
Thanks, Kate. If you'd like to receive a copy of the senior edition of the Highlander News Magazine delivered to your house for free, fill out the form at the link below. This is the most popular issue of the year, featuring the map of where seniors are headed next year. It also includes the clubs of editions that were put together by students in Journalism 1. Seniors will receive the issue automatically and do not need to fill out this form. They will need all the addresses by Wednesday morning, but if you miss the window, a limited number of copies will be available at the school this fall.
Three of McLean Dance Team's members will be holding a virtual dance lesson for kids of all ages and backgrounds every Friday at 11. If you'd like to sign up or just find out more, check out their website below, which contains the sign-up and examples of what you'll learn. Now to Lexi with sports.
Hey McLean, it's Lexi with your sports for the last time of the school year. In basketball, the Blazers were among the first two NBA teams to return to facilities 3 weeks ago when 8 of their rostered players showed up. Most of the league has since followed suit. The Mavericks opened their gym Thursday, leaving only the Celtics, Bulls, Pistons, Warriors, Knicks, Spurs, and Wizards shut down. In hockey, by a 29-2 vote, the executive board of the NHLPA approved a 24-team return-to-play format for the restart of the 2019 to the 2020 season. And the NHL announced its approval of the format on Tuesday. Soccer is also anticipating a return to regular playing. The Premier League is set to resume on June 17th after the clubs gave Project Restart the green light at a shareholders' meeting on Thursday. The league announced that Manchester City versus Arsenal and Aston Villa versus Sheffield United will be the first fixtures, taking all teams to 29 matches played. The remaining 90 games will then continue on June 19th, preceding a full match round program. That's all for your sports. Have a great and safe summer, Highlanders. Now back to your anchors.
Now for your global news. A new round of street protests erupted last week in the U.S. with the death of George Floyd, who was killed by Minnesota police. 15 states have deployed the National Guard and 31 cities have enacted a curfew. Fires and looting occurred in neighborhoods throughout D.C., and several storefronts were smashed with rocks. NBC News confirms that during the demonstrations, President Trump and his family were taken to the White House bunker.
As states begin to reopen places like beaches, parks, and non-essential businesses, COVID-19 is still on the rise, with the U.S. at 1.83 million cases. 37,000 of those cases are in Virginia. The U.S. has reached a sad milestone of 106,000 deaths. The CDC advises its citizens to continue following their guidelines about social distancing and wearing masks in public.
Northern Virginia moved into phase one of reopening on Friday. Parks can open during the day, which includes all FCPS, parks, and fields. Restaurants can open with outdoor seating at 50% capacity, and any public space in Virginia will require a face mask. What is it, Arman?
We've been hacked.
What? By who?
Roll the clip.
Michael, Edward, how long has it been? Since 2018, I haven't seen you since then.
Jackson, Edward, what a pleasant surprise. Ever since graduation, time really flies.
Michael Jackson, what a pleasant surprise. The sight of you both makes me break into rhyme.
I often find myself in a retrospective gaze, mulling over our McLean broadcasting days.
I agree with your statements. We are such silly kids. Sometimes when I'm alone, I'll throw in our vids.
If only we could turn back the days and the years.
Be back in McLean with all of our peers.
Like Jaffa, Ireland, Davis, and Krieger. When the new show was on, they were just so eager.
Now wait just a minute, my brothers in purity. Do you think McLean's YouTube has the same security?
Security? Like what? A password or a phrase?
Yeah, a cryptic code that keeps hackers away.
Back in our day, it was so simple and easy. But 2 years have passed. It can't be so breezy.
A mastermind we need to crack this old case. I know where he lies. Let's give him a chase.
Are you fellas free for the rest of the day? For methinks our journey takes us to Safeway.
Mask up, fellas. We must be good kids. or else Miss B will take down our bids.
Haru, we need you. It's YouTuber busted, and you're the only hacker we're trusted.
Buzz off, boys. I'm way too out of the game. From my position at Safeways, nothing is more important.
I just can't believe we got denied at the rim. That wasn't Haru. It just wasn't him.
With nowhere left to turn, the boys knew they had to do something drastic.
With a gulp in my tummy and a smile on my face, let's get back to work. There's no time to waste.
As sad as it is to see our friend gone, I have an idea that may keep our plan strong. The password of old was a simple concept, something so easy it could be overslept.
What was it? Remind me. I can't seem to recall. In fact, I can't remember much of high school at all.
Last I remembered, it was Rustin Rager in the name of our favorite journalism crusader.
No, you're mistaken. That was the password for STEM. And as you know, we don't associate with them. Mm-hmm.
When Haru left for STEM, it killed all our swagger. For the whole junior year, corner three dagger.
Won't go! Rebound box! Back out to Allen! His three-pointer! Bang!
I can't help but think. It's right under our noses. The moment we crack it, we'll be mighty like Moses.
And just like that, we bested the system with all of our flaming infinite wisdom.
Instead of doing what we want, we should be noble and report this mistake to the Highlander Mobile! We changed the password. Now they'll never get in.
This is for the people. Hatred never wins.
Yo, Ed. Hey, remember when Haru took Jesse to Clemmy, bro?
Well, I guess we're gonna have to negotiate to get the password back.
They seem like nice people, so I think we will be fine.
Because this is our last show of the year, here at WMHS News, we would like to thank the students who, in difficult circumstances, brought us into your home so we could still get McLean News. We are so thankful for the seniors who were with us for the past several years, changing our show for the better, especially our producer, Matt Wong. And none of this would have been possible without our great, tremendous advisor, Miss Benedict, who I've been working for the past 2 years and 4 years to come down the road. She's been with McLean since 2011. This show and the Highlander News Magazine would have not been where they are without her. So thank you so much to Ms. B and everyone else who has made this possible. We hope you stay safe in the coming months, and we can't wait to see you again in the fall.
Have a great summer, McLean.